And welcome to EOCL India Education Orbit Counseling and Link. Today is very special day for us as we are having none other than International Head of Volgograd State Medical University. So, ma'am, we are absolutely honored to have you here in India.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so ma'am, tell me, how was your visit?
Oh, this visit is really interesting. You know, I have a lot of impressions of India. And I must tell you that it's so nice to see different contrasts, because you know that Russia is also a country of contrasts. And just like India, it's also like that. So I'm enjoying my stay, and I feel like I'm enriching my cultural knowledge.
Okay, that's great. So I would like to ask some questions on behalf of students, those who want to study in MBBS abroad. So especially in Volgograd State Medical University. So my first question is, what is it about Russia that make it so preferable destination for international students?
Well, you know, to my mind, the main advantage of Russian medical education is the fact that it's very fundamental. No matter what we compare it with, still our six-year course covers completely everything of the medical knowledge. And in Russia, it's of highest concern how we teach medicine. This is one of the major concerns of our Minister of Education. That is why, you see, even if there are some changes in other educational programs, as for medical education, we do not make changes, and we do not divide it into bachelor's degree and master's degree, which is also very important, because a student, when he or she starts getting medical education, they have to get it completely, like without a chance that a person would have like an incomplete course of 4 years.
I agree with you, ma'am. Okay, so my next question is, tell us about what makes Volgograd State Medical University special and why it stands out of international students.
Well, there are several reasons, to be honest. For me, for example, this is the university where all my family studied. So there are a lot of dynasty doctors working and studying at this university, and we got a lot of international alumni who also studied, like the whole family, at our university. But you know, there are also some objective reasons. For example, our university is one of the top 10 best universities in Russia, not only among medical universities but also among all the universities. You can imagine the size of Russia.
Sure.
This is the first thing. The second thing, we've got a huge community of international students. For me, as an international studies specialist, it's of highest importance, because, you know, this intercultural community makes them feel more comfortable. We've got 3,000 international students currently, which makes us the third place in Russia according to the number of foreign students. And also, we have got the biggest community of Indian students in Russia.
It's great. So my next question is, does Volgograd State Medical University follow all the latest NMC guidelines?
Well, we are trying to do our best in following all of them. And you know that as far as we have got such a big community of Indian students, we are highly concerned about all of their problems, all of their issues that might occur. This is why we are following every single news about NMC requirements, and we do follow all of them. Necessarily, this is absolutely necessary, because we care about the future destiny of our students.
Hey, that's amazing. And my next question is, what kind of hostel or housing facility are offered by your campus?
Well, we have got three hostels around the city. This is quite traditional for Russia that we do not have hostels right inside the campus. But on the other hand, our hostels are situated not far from the main campus, which is also very important for international students. They need to know how to get there. And our hostels are located, like, for example, 3 kilometers away from the main campus, which is about 10 to 15 minutes by public transport. Public transportation system is very understandable, so this is very easy to get from hostel to the university campus. And as for the facilities, we do offer all the main facilities which are necessary for comfortable daily life. Well, our rooms are quite comfortably furnished, so there are all the necessary things for a student. Also, we do have kitchens, sometimes our students love to book together, and you know, when there are different national holidays, they do book some interesting international and national dishes. Also, we have got some laundry facilities. Of course, this is daily life. We cannot avoid this. So we do have this. And, you know, medical students have to put a lot of effort into studies. This is the reason why we also care about their fitness. So in every hostel of ours, we have got gyms. We also have a swimming pool. And starting from this year, we have got a shooting range.
Great.
Yes, to really
see. It's a very good thing for the new students.
Yes.
So my next question is very quickly asked question from by the students. When exactly did Volgograd State Medical University start teaching general medicine in English?
Well, I think I should start answering this question a little bit far. Because, you know, this university is really my pride, my personal pride and pride of the people who work there. We actually were founded, our university was founded in 1935, and since 1962. We have been welcoming international students. Of course, at that time, we had only Russian medium. That's why international students studied together with Russian students and even lived together in the hostels. But starting with the year 2000, we have had full English medium programs for international students.
Another important question is all the Indian students. So, how safe is Volgograd City for Indian students? Or does Indian student face any kind of discrimination or racism in campus or either in the city?
This is a very important question. Thank you for asking it, because I know that sending a kid to another country is very, very concerning, very worrying issue. I must say that Volgograd is safe from different points of view. Some people ask about the war or something like this. It's also important, let's say, when parents decide to send the kid to another country. Firstly, we're safe from the military operation. It's not a war. It's a military operation held on the territory of Ukraine. So we do not see any outcomes of this. This is the first thing. As for racism and any other kind of discrimination, we are highly against. And while we're building our international community, I mean, the members, the professors, the workers of international department, we do everything to prevent this. And it doesn't matter what nationality you are not supposed to be racistic. If there are some cases, you know, kids are kids, sometimes there is bullying and different things can occur. We avoid those conflicts by means of different measures. We take measures on different levels. First of all, in hostels, because students are supervised 24/7 there. There are also curators. These are people who supervise our students also 24/7. And whenever they have any kind of a problem, they can turn to these people and the problem will be solved. So we do not have any major problems like group racism or something like this, because we solve it immediately. And the university international community, now it's so tightly built. We are working on it. And even if we compare different universities around Russia, in some universities, there are student councils which are separated, like one student council for Russian students and one student council for internationals, like separated ones. We do not do it, because we believe that all the students should be together in one community. This also helps right away. They learn how to cooperate and they learn the intercultural communication. This also prevents racism.
So basically, there are very strict rules in Volgograd City to avoid these kinds of acts.
Yes.
So my next and my last question is, in your view, how does Indian student contribute to campus environment, both academically and the culture?
Well, also a nice question, by the way, because, you know, sometimes when people ask me about Indian students, I say that they are really similar to Russian students. In what way? These are some of the few students who come to study. Not to do something stupid, not to entertain themselves, but really to study. Because they understand that in order to become a real doctor, you need to put all your effort and you need to study very hard. So academically, I would say that Indian students are exemplar. They are examples for many other students from other countries. This is the first thing. The second thing is about cultural thing, have the cultural contribution. We love Indian holidays so much, you can't even imagine. When we have Diwali in our university, all the university celebrates that. There are some photos I can show you later. And when it is Diwali, all the university is painted with mehendi. All the employees, all the students. And one more thing, all the international and Russian students take part in preparation. Also, yeah, it's also very important. That's how they learn about the culture of India. And Indian students also take part together with other students.
But that's all about it. And thank you, ma'am, for sharing your valuable time and your deep insights with us. It's a detailed information about the Volgograd State Medical University, and it is very beneficial for the Indian student, those who want to study MBBS in Volgograd State Medical University.